chứ bỏ thôi.
Thank you.
to.
They were all my favourites. And that was by far the best way to start an assembly. Kia ora, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Kia ora. Girls, if you'd like to return to your seats.
Kia ora, we got there. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Nai mai, haere mai, matu whenua. Being at St Margaret's College is a privilege no matter what age you attend. It is a place where you are given all the nutrients to thrive. Being in the junior school is like a hothouse for growing. The conditions are perfect for everyone to become the best that they want to be. It doesn't matter what age or stage you are in life, whether you're 5 years old and have just started your St Margaret's journey, or year six, or like me, who began when they started St Margaret's as a five-year-old and are just maturing now. The foundations that are developed in the junior school are the highest quality because of the learning that takes place in the classroom, the opportunities to find a passion, being part of a team, working together as a team to achieve excellence, pushing comfort zones in a safe environment, and really building the confidence of our little sisters to become big sisters of St Margaret's. This year has been another year where growth conditions in our hothouse have been challenged, experimented with, cared for, and pruned. Once again, the threat of remote learning was a continued environmental pest that hovered around us all year. This year, we were more resilient to this and flexible, and the teachers displayed this, and they need a special mention for that, so thank you. The team of all teachers in the junior school are the reason our girls thrive. For the past 6.5 years, I have been blessed to lead this team. Together, we have accomplished many significant programs, from Friendology, leading the way in curriculum development, embedding the culture of the school through the Reds, embracing big sister's little sister opportunities, doubling the junior school role, celebrating success, our junior school sports programs, gold medal for gardens, performances, STEM programs and digital technology inclusion, an expansion of variety curriculum programs that start right from day one of school, and this is just to name a few. To Jen, Nikki, Michelle, Paulette, Megan, Sandra, Paula, Bindi, Lillian, and Audrey, it has been an absolute privilege to work with you. You have taught me and given me many reasons to grow in my role. I am in awe of your passion and your commitment to the children who have been in your care in our hothouse over the years. When we see an old girl from the junior school flourishing once they leave the junior school, the pride we take in knowing the beginning of their success started with us is something we treasure. To all their teachers who add energetic, innovative, inspiring teaching programs as part of the specialisation curriculum, which is an integral part of our junior school, having you guide these girls from a young age is not underestimated. And this also includes our fabulous Fran, Felicity and Vicky. Our thanks go to you all from the junior school. Role models are important in our school, and the juniors are exposed to so many to look up to and follow in their footsteps. For me, it's been no different. Working with the Ulti girls of Sian, Catherine, Jenny and Patchy, Diana, has been pivotal in ensuring that the junior school is directed with a positive purpose and ensuring we stay at the forefront of girls' education. To say I admire each one of them in the team is an understatement. To the broader leadership team of Sue and Sarah, Fionn, Steph, Belinda and Jane, I give you, and Brian, I give you my thanks for the insight and support and wisdom throughout this year and previous years. I found my tribe with these people, and I will dearly miss the discussions, challenges, and laughs we've had over the years. To me, the sign of a great principal is one that can rock a red tracksuit with such confidence and panache, and I can only hope. I would also like to, on behalf of the junior school, acknowledge those who work behind the scenes. Their job is not so much about educating, but ensuring that the wheels keep moving forward seamlessly. To the admin staff, the White House, Finance, a special mention to Laura Hughes, who I think became my PA at some point over the year, for their patience and their support of me asking endless questions many times, and of the junior school. To Sharon and her team, and Pete and his team, and Paula and her team, there was never a job that was too big or too difficult for them, especially this year. And finally, to the parents and the girls of the junior school. You are the reason we love our job. You are the reason we are constantly improving and ensuring we provide the best possible experience for our girls. It is not an ideal situation we find ourselves in when we are unable to welcome you all into our space, and for many, especially those new to our school, being unable to connect with other families or visit the classrooms or form a relationship with your teachers is something that we too have found difficult. Without a doubt, the highlight of the year for me is the junior school girls. You fill my bucket every day. Every time you say hello to me, share your stories, your achievements, be kind to each other, grow and have fun every day, you are the main reason I have loved working here. I have been indebted to you all for the past few years. The support and encouragement and relationships I have formed with you all are something that I am eternally grateful for and I am humbled by. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Hello, everyone. On behalf of the Trust Board, it's great to see you all here today, and welcome to those watching via live stream for this, the Junior Prize Giving, undoubtedly the highlight of the St Margaret's calendar. I would like to take this opportunity to thank a number of people, and I've been asked to keep this brief so that we can get on with the important business of handing out the prizes. First and foremost, to the girls from the year ones who have just completed their first year of the journey here at St Margaret's, to the girls in year six who are about to transition to the middle school. I'm sure that you all aspire to make the most of your opportunities and challenges that you are presented with, and to celebrate your progress and achievements no matter how big or small. Congratulations on your gold medal from the Grow Otatahi Garden Festival, a great achievement. Thank you all for your valuable input to the life of the school. To the teaching and support staff, thank you for your unwavering commitment and true passion to the education of the girls. You always go above and beyond your normal duties and give freely of your time to enable growth in co-curricular activities. We thank you so much for your dedication to developing the girls on their journey through St Margaret's. We also thank you for your resilience and commitment as you led our girls through another period of remote teaching and learning. And I can only imagine how challenging it must be to be teaching new entrants online when they had only been at school for a very short period of time. I congratulate you on what a great job you have done, knowing full well that some of you had your own children's education at home to coordinate as well. As we are all too well aware, we can never foresee when these challenges will be thrust upon us, but your ability to adapt and provide ongoing support and care has been exceptional. I would also like to acknowledge all of our wider parent community for being amazingly supportive during this period of remote learning. Thank you very much. This brings me to Mrs. Calder. Julie, you leave us this year, and on behalf of the Trust Board and the entire school community, thank you for your unwavering passion and focus on providing the girls an exceptional educational opportunity over your time at SMC. We wish you all the best for your future, and thank you for all that you've contributed to St Margaret's. And I'm sure you'll be a great advocate for SMC, and the pipeline will continue for girls coming over here. The board would like to specifically thank Mrs. Patchett, Diana, for your strong leadership of St Margaret's to provide an outstanding educational service and to grow well-rounded individuals and nurture each girl's unique strengths. Thank you very much. To all the girls, staff and parents, Merry Christmas. Enjoy your summer break with your friends and family. Thank you. Thank you.
draw the short straw as to which act to follow. Man, that was great, girls. What fast singing. And how amazing to be able to learn all of those words. Gosh, so clever. Well done. Should we give them another big round of applause? Well done. So good. Tēnā koutou katoa, nā mihi nui ki a koutou. Listen, when I went to school, girls, I had an opportunity to learn French as the other language that I got to learn. And you're so lucky at St. Margaret's. My goodness, you get a chance to learn Te Reo Māori, you get Chinese, French, and Spanish. They are fantastic to be able to learn some of those other languages. And then when I went to university, I actually got to learn a bit of Latin, which was quite cool because it helped me to understand lots of different things, particularly terms used around medicine. Latin is really helpful, but it also helped for me when I came to St. Margaret's because I was able to understand this phrase, Beate mundo corde. That's written in Latin, and that means blessed are the pure in heart. It's a nice motto to have for a school. And Latin also led me to one of my really favourite sayings, which is this next one. Nutrimentum spiritus. You can kind of see some of the words that you might recognize from English. Nutrimentum, kind of like nutrition, so maybe something to do with food, and spiritus, maybe something to do with your spirit. And that's exactly what it is. Nutrimentum spiritus means food for the soul. And it's actually in an inscription that you see above the Berlin Royal Library, which I think is appropriate because it's actually said that reading is to the mind what exercise is to the body. Yeah. Sadly, for many adults, and me included, in the busyness of our lives, it's often the things that are best for us that we put off for when we have more time. That means probably reading and exercise. But while I read something every day, I'll admit that reading for pleasure is more of a holiday treat, and I do look forward to the escape that it affords me. It's hard to imagine a more powerful antidote to a full-on day than to lose yourself in a great story. And the beauty of reading is that there is something to capture anyone's curiosity and imagination. Stephen King's a famous author, and he said, "Books are uniquely portable magic." But perhaps the most powerful magic comes from picture books. Now, picture books may appear simple, but they can be very complex, and they often have something really important to say or to give to all ages and all generations. They're written to be shared, and a wonderful opportunity for parents and teachers and principals to communicate with young people. So, let me share one with you today. This is a New Zealand publication. It's a story about luck called The Boy and the Lemon, written by James Herman and illustrated by Juliet Burton. I've got the pictures up here to follow. Way, way out in outer space, where asteroids float and comets race, upon a planet never found, a lemon tree grew upside down. And off one branch, far from the ground, a single lemon, ripe and round, fell from that tree, past stars, the moon, then satellites, then clouds, then soon. That lemon fell toward the earth, where people gawked its giant girth. Among them was a boy called Jack, whose house, with an almighty whack, became the broken resting place of this great fruit from outer space. "A lemon," cried his mother. "Oh, what will we do? Where will we go?" But despite her stress and woe, Jack doubted this was such a blow. "Mother, look," said Jack, "I'm not so sure it's time to lose the plot. Pick yourself up off the ground. Let's turn our rotten luck around." So with his worried mum in tow, Jack set out and got to know a multitude of marvellous giant fruit removalists. First, Glob the giant, mighty strong, whose hulking arms were twice as long as Jack himself, and for a song, that giant Glob would lift that fruit up off the roof and distribute its rind and juice to somewhere far, perhaps Myanmar or Qatar. Secondly was dangerous Dwight, who specialized in dynamite. He said, I'll serve that lemon right. Sit tight, wait till you see the sight of your great lemon by my means blowing into smithereens. Third and last was Magic Max, who turned to that mother of Jack's and said, I make lemons disappear without a trace into thin air. How does that strike you, my dear? And then, as if to prove his point, he pointed to her purse of coins, and with a wave he filled it fat and said, just pay with some of that. Three brilliant choices Jack had found, and which had made his mother proud. Three ways to put this thing put right. Giants, wizard, dynamite. Before they chose which way to go, with his thoughts Jack sat alone. He realized that unbeknown, a hunch of his had grown and grown and turned into his very own idea to fix this lemon fix, to fix it with the best of tricks. Jack, of course, to be polite, apologized to Max and Dwight and Glob for taking up their time. He spun around and made a line straight home to start on his design. Jack worked non-stop from noon to nine, but whatever he had in mind remained entirely behind a veil of mystery until, finally, he yelled, Mum, will you come and tell me what you think? To her surprise and with a wink, Jack smiled and handed her a drink. What's this? She asked, feeling confused at why the lemon hadn't moved. Just taste it, Mum. Taste what I've made. She did, and it was lemonade. And so the giant lemon stayed, a gift from way out outer space. What seemed a grim and dreadful case was super lucky, truly great. So Jack, his mum, and all his mates forgot the broken roof and rafters and house full of fun and laughter, drank lemonade happily ever after. Now, that story is actually based and inspired on the work of a famed professor, a British psychology professor, who undertook a major study of luck in the 1990s. Discovering that lucky people actually exhibit certain attitudes and behaviours that can be learned, and anybody then can improve their own luck. So the first thing you need to learn is think positive. While his mum is distressed and freaked out about the lemon, Jack is positive that it's not such a bad thing and actually everything will turn out okay. When we think positive, usually things turn out well. Luck loves positive people. Second one that Jack did, he was curious. Jack was open to new ideas. He got out, he met new people, he explored all the opportunities of having that lemon removed. Whenever you meet new people and have new experiences, you create chances to be lucky. Number three, back yourself. Now, Jack found three great ways to get rid of the lemon, but something inside of him was nagging and knew that there was an even better option. So listening to his own hunch, he thinks and realizes that inside the lemon is something awesome, lemonade. So if you listen to your own intuition and follow it, usually better things will happen. And the last one, find the silver lining. A life well lived is prone to the odd setback. Things aren't always going to go according to plan. Perhaps not a giant lemon falling on your house, but things are not quite likely to go according to every plan you make. Remember, there's always a way to make something good out of a bad situation. If life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Now, there's a message in that for all of us here, I think, but especially our Year 6 girls. As you step into the middle school, to new teachers, new subjects, lockers and the CAF, we do not need to wish you luck. For now you know that you have the power to make your own. I know Ms. Gray and her team know how to help you to think positive, to be curious, to back yourself, and to turn any lemons you might get into lemonade. So go forth and conquer. I know you'll make us all very proud. As we carry on now to celebrate excellence and endeavour in the junior school, let's join in acknowledging the girls who receive accolades. Then, as we step into the summer break, may it offer you a time to spend time with family, to read a few books, perhaps enjoy some fresh lemonade, and to remember how lucky we all are to be part of St. Margaret's College. Tēnā koutou katoa. Thank you.
Hi, we're the Ladybugs, and today we're going to be playing Impossible.
Impossible.
going to come back in 10 years' time and to your rock concert where your first album has been given a Tui Award. You were absolutely fantastic, so thank you very, very much. And I'd like to give you another round of applause. I thought you were amazing. So now we come to the awards part of our wonderful prize giving. And just a reminder, girls, that if your name is called out, to come down one side and wait so that you can have your 5 minutes of fame and smile at the cameras. That would be wonderful. Our first set of prizes are being awarded by Mrs. Patchett, so it's lovely to see you. And our first set are to recognise our new entrants in recognition for a fabulous start to the junior school. So here we go. Amelia Baldwin-Swith. See if we remember what we practised. And we do, we're away. Isla Ballantyne. Amara Dhaliwal. Honor Ferguson. Dariti Gwasami. Eden Hughes. Madison Mackey. Chriselle Tockley and Nina Vassy. These are our new entrants. Well done, girls. One more, and Nina. Nina, there you go. Well done. Great start to their school life. And look, we're so professional. To our year one. Just wait for our new entrants to sit down again. They're doing a great job. Girls, you can sit anywhere now. Yeah. You've got your certificates. You're all sorted. You can sit with your friends. Yeah, absolutely, and have a look at your certificates. It's to year one, Sissy Evans, Academic Whakapaukaha. Imogen Grimshaw, Spirit of St. Margaret's. Well done, girls. Year two, Bella Elwood, Academic Whakapaukaha. You ones, you can go back now. Well done. Sneak back. Good girls. We're doing this all on our own. We're great. Isla Hughes, Spirit of St. Margaret's. Year three. Inka Somerville-Smith, Academic Whakapaukaha. Molly Levenger, Spirit of St. Margaret's. Well done, girls. So thank you, Year 3, and Mrs. Patchett. Thank you. I'm going to invite Mr.
Mr. Hanrahan up now to do the Year 4 Sixes. So Year 4, Henrietta Williamson, Academic Whakapaukaha. Sylvie Roberts, Academic Excellence. Georgia Lacey, Spirit of St. Margaret's. Well done, girls. Year 5, Harriet Lee, Academic Whakapaukaha. Sienna O'Connell, Academic Excellence. Isabella Blakely, Spirit of St. Margaret's. Well done. Year 6. Connie Coreno, Academic Whakapaukaha. Ella Liu, Academic Excellence. Georgia Douglas, Spirit of St. Margaret's. Well done to our Year 6. I now invite, thank you, Mr. Hanrahan, great job. I now invite our Year 4 to 6 choir to come up, please.
Hello, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Mimi Dyer, and I've had the privilege of being head of junior school this year. I'd like to start off by saying a warm welcome to you, and thank you for coming, including all the parents tuning in on our live stream. This time last year, when I was appointed the position of head of junior school, I have to admit, I didn't know what was coming. And to be quite honest, I had my heart set on being head of house. But as it turned out, being head of junior school this year has helped me in more ways than I'll ever have time to explain. I knew from the moment I stepped foot into the school for my last first day ever that my year 13 would be nothing short of a chaotic yet fantastic experience. Alongside Miss Kuldall, who I have been very lucky to have as my mentor this year, I knew that I wanted to make a memorable year for all those involved in the best part of the school. Now, I might be biased because I started my own SMC journey in 2012 at the ripe age of 8 in my year 4 class. Most of my favourite memories throughout my time here at St Margaret's have been in junior school, and I will never forget them. I could go on and on about the mischievous things my friends and myself would get up to in those early years, but I thought I'd share a few lasting memories that will continue to stay with me as I leave the school for the last time. The first thing that comes to mind was the shattering of the light bulbs in Miss Sheldon's Year 6 class. Now, it was a rainy day, and there's too much energy for one classroom to handle. So my friends and I decided we'd start kicking a ball from one end of the classroom to the other. Of course, we got told to take it outside or sit quietly with the others and make loom bands, for those of you who remember what those are, but we told her that no, we have it under control. We did not. As the ball went flying from one end of the classroom straight into the light bulb, shattering the glass all over the floor. Now, our first instinct was to just, you know, play dumb, say, oh, the light bulb must have mysteriously fell from the ceiling on its own and we had nothing to do with it. But of course, we walked to Miss Sheldon on lunch duty with our tails between our legs and we told her what happened. We cleaned up the remaining glass as the maintenance men brought in the new light bulb and we sat down for the rest of the day and wrote letters to our parents apologising for our stupidity. Needless to say, we didn't throw balls inside after that. However, the most memorable memory was again with Miss Sheldon in Year 6 on an average summer afternoon in reading time. As I recall, Miss Sheldon was wearing a tight, mid-calf, A-frame skirt and a flowy top. Mrs. Sheldon leaned forward to a chair, facing away from me to get something, and just as that moment, I leant forward to pick up my reading book. And Miss Sheldon then stood up, and my head proceeded to get stuck in her skirt. It was quite a fright for both of us. And I'll leave it to you, for the rest of the story, but we still talk about it to this day, and she now wears flowy skirts everywhere she goes. Walking into the school every day, or even around campus, having all these little sisters yelling my name or running up to give me a hug or a high five brightened up my day, no matter how busy or stressed I was at that point in time. I knew that I could rely on these girls to bring a smile to my face, and I can imagine they bring smiles to all your faces when they come home from school every day. The memories these girls will make in the next few years will stay with them for a long time to come, and I hope that they will remember the cool things we got up to this year. Due to COVID restrictions, our junior school disco was cancelled, but that didn't stop us from having a great year. From teddy bear picnics to four square competitions to big sister, little sister time, I hope you have all enjoyed yourself. I've truly loved every moment of being head of junior school, and I'm very sad to leave here at the end of this year. Miss Kuldall, thank you for everything you have done, not only for me, but for the junior school also. You are a bright light and you'll be sorely missed next year. I wish you the best on your next chapter in your life. This brings me to the end of my speech, but I just wanted to leave you with a quote in true SMC fashion. Sometimes you'll never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory. So have fun and enjoy your time as an SMC girl. Thank you.
An inspiring speech from our leader. So leadership is not about leading, but about helping out and supporting and having the needs of the people at the centre of all you do. And leadership's not about wearing a badge, but about being reliable, responsible and creative, and being able to relate to everyone is also key. So I would like to, at this stage, thank Mimi for her contribution to this year as our head of junior school prefect, and whose company we have enjoyed throughout the year. We wish you so many good wishes for your future into the adult world, and hope that this crown, and it's the self-manager crown, we hope that this crown is a reminder of us as you venture forth. So, crown to you, my lady. Thank you. I'd also like to introduce you to Annabelle March, who's here today. So Annabelle, do you want to just pop up and turn around and face everybody, including all the cameras? And Annabelle is our 2022 junior school prefect, and she's also an old girl of the junior school, which is exciting. So best of luck for next year. And of course, our lots of thanks goes out to the junior school, all our junior school house leaders, our community leaders, and our head sacristans for their outstanding contribution to the junior school this year. I'd like them and all of our other school leaders for their outstanding service. So that's the junior school kapa haka leaders, the librarians, the wet day monitors, the IT monitors, all of those people to stand so that we can give you a round of applause for all your hard work to keep our junior school ticking along. Thank you, girls. You've made a world of difference. Thank you. This year's year five group are a fine example to us all on how to stretch ourselves outside our comfort zone with an unprecedented amount of girls applying for all the leadership positions. So this group of leaders are just the beginning of our leadership opportunities, and at the beginning of next year we'll also be acknowledging other leaders as programs are developed in 2022. But without further ado, Mrs. Patchett, if you could help us, please. In 2022, our junior school leaders are Head Sacristan Alexandra Pawsey, Sienna O'Connell. House leaders, Rose Griffiths, Annabelle Smallman, Annabelle Foster, Methali Wajayasena, Mackenzie Crampton, Maisie Diver. Community leaders, Portia Ferguson, Alia Wu. Give these girls a round of applause. Well done, girls. Thank you. I now invite the Big Sister, Little Sister performance group up. And this is a fine example of how our big sisters in St. Margaret's tirelessly support the junior school. And they've come to perform for us second year in a row, which is very exciting. So take it away, girls.
Travel on, there's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door where blues won't haunt you anymore. where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.
It was a great finish. Great finish. We now move through to our special prizes. And it is with great pleasure that we present these. And before we begin our individual prizes, I'd just like to do a special award to the whole of the junior school. So every year, the Class Environmental Initiative Award is handed to somebody from new entrant through to year 13. And this year, the junior school has been awarded this award because of their fabulous effort in the Grow Otutahi garden. So Mrs. Double, I'd like you to come up again, please. We did this at the senior school, but I think the junior school need to give ourselves a round of applause, really. Well done. Junior school graduates, so we'd like to acknowledge these students who started their journey with the junior school. So when you hear your name, if you could come down, please. Connie Coreno, Leah Moore, who started at preschool, Alice Murfitt, Isabel Masters, and Beatrix Smulders. Well done, girls. Well done, you can return. Just to acknowledge. And we move through to our awards. So Georgia Lacey, Excellence in Visual Arts, Year 4. Isabella Blakely, Excellence in Visual Arts, Year 5. And Greta Costello, Excellence in Visual Arts, Year 6. Harriet Goff, excellent in performing arts. Ella Liu, excellent in instrumental music. And Catherine Nichols, excellent in junior contemporary music and the Library Cup. Well done. Queenie Q, excellent in music. Athena Wu, Junior School Cup for Mathematics. Grace Miller, the Lynn Kennedy Speech Cup and the Prue Watson Cup for Excellence in Literacy. This year, sporting trophies have been awarded co-jointly, which highlights our junior school talents and skill in sport. So too, Maisie Diver, the Phoebe Steele Cup, is joint shared with Alice Jeffries for the Phoebe Steele Cup. Congratulations, girls. The Junior Sports Participant of the Year, the Car Girls Trophy, is awarded to Alexandra Campbell and Greta Costello. There's a few famous names on there. Well done, girls. Congratulations. These next awards are our highest achievement in the junior school, and these awards are not about academic success or a skill-based success, rather an acknowledgement of the strength of character in individual students who epitomise the St Margaret's ethos. So our first award is a Smart Memorial Cup for Courage, and this is awarded to any girl from new entrant through to year 13 at St Margaret's who has overcome personal challenges throughout the year. This recipient has endured major surgery this year as well as physical challenges. Throughout this year, this person has always displayed courage and enthusiasm for all events and programs, and even when she was carried on stage to perform. The recipient of the Smart Memorial Cup for Courage is awarded to Phoebe He. Well deserved. The Friendship Cup is decided upon the votes of the years from new entrant through to the Year 6 girls, and the criteria for this award is based on girls who are not only friendly to their class peers, but also are friendly and supportive and caring to all the girls in the junior school. And this year's recipient is highly deserving of this cup. So, the recipient for the Friendship Cup for 2021 is Georgia Douglas. Stay right where you are, Georgia. You deserve to be in the limelight for a wee bit longer. The Kai Manawa Nui Strong of Heart. It is a very special part of the junior school, as it was commissioned by the late Miles Coco, who is also our school's much treasured kaimatua. In honour of the great work that Miles did in our school, it has been awarded, and it means strength or strong of heart. The criteria of this trophy is for a girl who shows strength and character, a sense of self, perseverance, kindness, and being a strong role model which supports the aurora of the junior school. And these are the attributes that we remember Miles by. The recipient of the Kai Manawa Nui Strong of Heart Award is Greta Costello. The St Margaret's Cup is awarded to the student in Year 6 who best demonstrates the qualities and values of the college. And these include academic performance and effort, involvement in school activities, relationships with adults and students, sportsmanship and spiritual qualities. This year's recipient is a high-achieving all-round girl who holds all the true values of St Margaret's: honesty, integrity, loyalty, caring and compassion, and throughout the year often displayed these qualities, not only in the junior school, but also out in the wider school. The recipient of the St Margaret's Cup for 2021 is Alexandra Campbell. Congratulations, girls, very proud. So now we move through to our Year 6 presentation, which is kind of the highlight of our prize giving. So Year 6, you're ready to move on to the middle school part of your life, but before you do, we want you to take the time to remember where you have come from, reflect on the growth that you have made in every area of your life, and you leave us with a kite of tools of friendship, relationships, knowing how to learn, experience success and challenges, and learning from each other. But most importantly, you're going to take your reds. My last three pieces of advice are you to these. My last two pieces of advice to you are these. You are the author of your own school journey. You will be faced with many, many opportunities to grow, try something new, be challenged in so many ways, whether that be new sports or arts opportunities, new friends or social groups. It's the new opportunities or learning challenges. But remember, you are the only one that's holding you back. And this piece of advice coming through now, Lillian, if you could follow through with that, is something that I have lived for and something that very recently helped me make a major decision in my life. Don't ever be scared of your potential. You don't know how far you will go if you don't give it a go. We are really looking forward to seeing you grow and to achieve your dreams and to make new goals. Always look ahead, but never forget where you have come from. And here is a little movie just to remember how far you have come.
It's a girl game. And why you wish you could join?
So to our year sixes, I invite you and your groups to come up and receive your final year six surprise. Alicia Ann, Elizabeth Bedgood, Alexandra Campbell, Connie Coreno, Bella Chang. Greta Costello, Savannah Dallison, Georgia Douglas, Eva Grace, Alice Jeffries, LLU. Isabel Masters, Grace Miller, Leah Moore, Alice Murfitt, Catherine Nichols. Charlotte Park, Queenie Q, Beatrix Smulders, Emma Wong, Athena Wu, and Sophia Wu. Can I please have my 2 year five helpers?
Connie. It'll pick you up, Leah. Don't worry about it. Just speak loudly. It'll get you. There you go.
And Steve is first. Thank you, Steve.
So, in keeping with the tradition of our school, we honour the virtues of St. Margaret, our patron saint. We kindle this light that the virtues of St. Margaret may dwell within us. And may this candle remind us of Christ's light in our lives, and may we be Christ's light in our world. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God of hope and love, we give to you, Year 5, Christ's light and to shine in your hearts and lives in 2022. We ask God through this light, Christ's light, to guide and help you accept the responsibilities. You are future leaders and will bring with you your gifts as leaders in the junior school at St. Margaret's in 2022.
Year 5, stand, please.
God of hope and love, we accept this candle, Christ's light in our lives. We accept the responsibility you have given us for the junior school in 2022. We ask God to guide you, Year 6, as you go on with confidence and araha on your journey. May your dreams and lives be those that you have imagined.
No, girls, we haven't finished yet. You can't go just yet. Yeah, I know you're really keen to start the next part of your life, but we'll just give you a quick wee blessing before you go. Year 5, you sit down, please. I love it. It's their ice cream. They want the ice cream.
They can smell it already. Would the adults and students please stand as we farewell the Year 6 students from the Junior School of St. Margaret's. Kia noho te warua o te runga, rawa, kia tato. The divine spirit dwells in us. We send forth our Year 6 students, confident of your care for them in their futures. Bless them and us in this season of Christmas. Never stopping, never giving up, unbreaking, always and forever, loving God. You call us once again to celebrate the coming of your Son. Please work with us to remove those things which hinder love of you. Then when Jesus comes, he may find us waiting in awe and wonder for him. Bless us all with your grace, your hope, your peace, your joy, and most of all, your love. And may the blessing of God, Creator, Redeemer, and Giver of life, be with you and remain with you and all those you love, now and forever. Amen.
Now, I know Miss Gray and her team are really looking forward to welcoming our junior school girls into the middle school, but there's one other person that's going to be graduating from the junior school today, and that's Mrs. Calder. So I think I said before that books are uniquely portable magic. So we would just like to send you away with a little bit of portable magic as a reminder of your time in the junior school. And all of these girls here have been authors in that book. So if I could just ask Savannah and Charlotte, they've got a book, I think, that they're here to present to you. A fond farewell from the junior school. No. Now, I think our Year 6s, we're going to offer you a round of applause as you make your way up the stairs and are welcomed to the middle school then by Ms. Gray, and then we'll follow, I think, with Ms. Calder. If you could just stand in here with me.
Lovely.
Yeah.
So, finally graduating.
Yes.
My parents
we'll send the Year 6s up first. Thank you, girls. Let's give them a big round of applause.
I think we've got a special line on here. And so we've got